Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Well, in this part we'll see or solve a special problem, especially if we work with Getx. You'll often see that your controllers are being deleted from memory, okay, and that causes a lot of problem. Like over here, as you can see from the log, it says that ProductController onDelete method has been called, and that also means that this ProductController has been deleted. At the same time, popular product, this controller also has been deleted from the memory, okay? And even though here it looks healthy, but if I click on this, we'll get error, and it says that range error invalid value. While definitely that error is quite understandable, it is trying to access something from a list, but it couldn't find it. Now, it is trying to access a list from either product controller or popular product, okay? Yeah, so once I click on them, that happens, and we have this error, of course, but this error has nothing to do with basically direct range or your list error, okay? Now, if we take a look over here, once again, we'll see that it says that it created, and we are trying to get it, okay? Now, once you click on this, actually, they're being created once again. But now everything happens here too fast. So, well, the app didn't really wait for them to be created, initialized, and then get the value and then go ahead, right? Okay, anyway. But now, if we see the documentation of Getx, it will say that if you have your dependencies, and in your dependencies, you should use LazyPut, where you load them lazily, and over here you can put a parameter which is called fenix true, and if you do that, the parameters or the controllers won't be deleted. They would be in the memory. Let's run it one more time. Okay, so here you see it's onDelete called. Okay, all right, now this is happening for my product controller and popular product, these two controllers. Now, if you come over here, you see popular product, I have this parameter set, fenix true, and popular product the same, but yet they get deleted, okay? Well, but in the document, they said that they would be always in the memory. Well, that is partly true. It could be a little buggy the way they are doing it, because it's still under development, active development, I would say. But it's a good package. But now here, so we are still having this problem. But now, if you see, well, this is the log that I have here, if we see carefully. So a lot of the controllers and repo controllers or product repos, they've been initialized. And then what happens here? Here I go to this splash route, as you can see. Let's take a look one more time. Okay. So here, so you saw the splash screen, right? You saw the splash screen. So this is the splash screen, actually. Okay, and then we come over here. So over here, we go to a splash route, right? Okay, take a look from here. And once it goes to splash route, and they delete these two controllers, all right, even though I have them set up over here. Okay, now go ahead and take a look at this splash controller. The splash route. Well, the splash route is over here. If we take a look from Get Material app inside, we have the splash route. A splash route, what it does, go ahead and calls this Dart class splash screen, and then it takes us to initial route. And over here, we go to the home page. This is the page actually we see. Now, here, this is the catch. So if you use Get.offNamed to redirect to a different route, what it does, it's deleted the previously loaded controllers. That's what it does. Well, it does to save memory, okay? All right, but now instead of this one, if we use toNamed, you'll see that our app would be working and as expected, okay? Now over here, you see that it's going to main route, and we like earlier, we didn't see that product controller on delete has been called, right? If we see the log over here, as you see, none where it says that they have been deleted. It's all been created, right? Yes. So now if we click on this, we can hover over. We can do lots of different things over here. We can add to cart. We can come over here and we can check out. We can go to the home page and we can travel through our app. We can do whatever we like. Okay, so this is one way to solve this issue. If your memory, if your controllers, they get deleted, that's one way to solve the issue. Okay, let's say you really want to use off-named, okay, and you don't want to use to-named, then what we could do, we can come over here to our main file, main.dart file over here, where we have this my app. So we could wrap this around get builder. Okay, so here we do get builder, and here we do product product controller. Like those controllers, they get deleted, so I can put them here and wrap my app around it. Okay, yeah, and then it would keep things in the memory. We'll see it soon. Okay, all right, so now here we do return, and once more get builder, and here we don't need to pass anything, just like earlier one. We'll pass empty controller, and here we do popular product. Okay, and from here we'll return, and within it we'll return our get material app. Okay, and also we need a return statement over here. Okay, now the error is gone. So now anyway, so if we see the splash screen, I'm still using off, but here I wrapped my get material app using get builder, and the controllers I always want to keep in the memory. These are the controllers. So if you wrap your get material app using your desired controller, that controller would be always in the memory. Okay, let's restart app and we'll see that everything is there. Okay, all right, it's still there, right? So we can scroll through, we can do all the things we want. We can go over here, we can check out, come over here. Let's see. Yeah, so things are all pretty much over here. Okay, so that's how it works. So if you have this problem with that, your controllers get deleted, so either you can use change the type of the method function you use from get, or wrap everything around your everything inside get builder using your desired controller. Thank you so much.